Hi, I'm Joy Macknight, Technology Editor at The Banker, and I'm here today at Innovate Finance, the global summit, and I'm here with Nick Hungerford, CEO of Nutmeg, which is an online investment manager. Nick, can you tell us a little bit about Nutmeg and maybe some of the pain points that you are trying to solve with the company?
Sure. I mean, in essence, we're a very simple, old-fashioned wealth management company who help people look after their savings and investments. But the thing that we do differently, the way we innovate, is by lowering the barriers of entry. So we democratize the market and allow people with as little as £500 to get the same service, to get the same investment management that they would if they had £5 million. And that's a really exciting thing for us to do because we're introducing a lot of first-time investors to the world of wealth management.
How did you get the idea in the beginning? Like, how did it start?
Well, it was a complete accident, of course, as most of these ideas are. I actually set out to write a business plan to build a dating website that would connect clients with advisors, because it's so hard to find an advisor who suits you. Usually you just go to one who's referred. But what if you're someone who likes learning and you want to find an advisor who's a good teacher? What if you're an entrepreneur and you want to find an advisor who can deal with people with little patience? So that was the idea behind it all. But as we went through that, we discovered that advisors didn't actually mind who they took on as clients. What they were after was as many assets as possible, and their propositions were largely similar. So we thought, well, if we can make the proposition better value for money and lower the barriers to entry and keep it at the same standard in terms of service and performance, why wouldn't everyone do that? And so it's proved very popular.
And you were just speaking on a panel that talked about the fintech disruptors. How would you say Nutmeg acts as a disruptor within the financial services industry?
I'd say there's two ways that Nutmeg is a disruptor. The first one is in lowering barriers to entry for customers. So we open up an industry which has traditionally only been available to the 1% or less than 1%, those people with £500,000 worth of savings or more. And I think that by doing that and by doing that at fair value and you know, relatively lower cost, we've totally disrupted the industry. I think the second way that we disrupt is through the way that we, show transparency on the website. So before Nutmeg, no companies showed their performance on their website. Before Nutmeg, it was very hard to get a minute-by-minute view of what you were investing in and how it was doing and your charges in pounds and pence. So I think that we've come to the market and shown that not only can you provide the service to everybody, but you can do it in a way that's better, more effective, more efficient for the consumer.
And then there's been a lot of debate about this area being regulated, and I know Nutmeg is regulated by the FCA. How important is that to you and to the industry as a whole, do you think?
Well, unlike some other financial technology companies, it was never a question for us. I mean, we do a very similar thing to companies that have been around for 250, 300 years. We manage people's investments. You know, security of assets, building trust, great customer service, all of that to us is absolutely paramount, has been from day one. So we went through a regulatory process as a matter of course. I mean, we would have done it if we had built in the traditional way of high net worth clients and face to face, or whether we do it online and for everybody. So it's absolutely essential. We can't survive without it. I think the key point for us though is that because we're doing this for customers who might be investing for the first time, we in some way have to lead the regulatory process and understand how those people are going to react to things like market dips, what kind of communications we need for them, and measure, you know, what we can do from a client regulatory perspective and feed that back into the FCA.
Excellent. And what are your plans, let's say, for the next year?
Lots of plans. We spent 2015 building a lot of back office technology, so this year I think is going to be a lot more about front office and customer product, which we're actually really excited about to get launching, because it's been a while since Nutmeg released something, you know, totally new to the market. Last year we did our pension service, which is now proving you know, to be very popular, but we need to get more innovation like that out. So look for changes to our investment models, changes to the way that we handle client onboarding, you know, more mobile activity, so on and so forth. Hopefully a few good surprises on the client interface as well.
So thank you so much.
Thank you very much.